SUVs used to be very specific, purpose-built, outdoorsy adventure vehicles. They weren't comfortable, they weren't luxurious, and somewhere along the way they've become 8-passenger family vehicles meant to replace minivans and station wagons. Well, the trend we're noticing for the 2020s is to try and recapture some of that outdoorsy magic. We've seen it from a number of automakers, and the latest one to join that trend is Nissan. This is the 2022 Nissan Pathfinder, and it has new styling inside and out that's meant to be a little bit more rugged, a little bit more outdoorsy. It has a new transmission, made it up to its V6 engine, and it has some new systems meant to help it go off-road a little bit better. But it still has all of the luxury amenities and connectivity and safety equipment that modern families are demanding. So we've come here to Southeast Michigan to drive the new 2022 Nissan Pathfinder to see if all the changes they've made to make it a little bit more rugged and outdoorsy have really paid off. The last Pathfinder was a generic blob-shaped thing that bore no family resemblance to the chunky original 1986 model at all. This new fifth generation model is a complete departure from the last one and incorporates some styling cues from the original Pathfinder, such as the forward swept C-pillar, the three-slot grille, and the overall squared off thick body styling. It's actually a little shorter than the outgoing model, but changes its proportions by being taller and wider. I have to say, it works much, much better than the last Pathfinder in terms of looks. The slim headlights taper into the wide and prominent fenders, with the taillights stretching across the rear to again emphasize the Pathfinder's new width. Its geometric looks make the new Pathfinder feel like a larger vehicle than the one it's replacing, but the overall dimensions don't actually change all that much. Suffice it to say, it looks and feels big. This was not an effort to slim down the SUV, this was an effort to make it look more rugged and aggressive, and it worked rather well. Powering the 22 Pathfinder is the same 3.5-liter V6 that's in the outgoing model. It makes 284 horsepower and 259 pounds-feet of torque, which is unchanged from the previous Pathfinder. What's new is what that engine is connected to, a conventional 9-speed automatic transmission, replacing the unloved 2-speed continuously variable automatic transmission in the old Pathfinder. That change is meant to improve the Pathfinder's off-road ability, its towing durability, its driving dynamics, and more. And in most ways, it delivers. Driving the new Pathfinder is best done at a relaxed pace, as if the whole family is on board for a ride and you don't want kids dropping juice boxes or grandma to stress any joints. With moderate acceleration, the V6 is perfectly adequate. The new 9-speed auto shifts smoothly and calmly, and the whole experience is of a big, heavy SUV doing what it does best, ferrying the brood to soccer practice or the mall in quiet comfort. The transmission does hunt a lot for its gears, but with 9 speeds to play with, this is to be expected. Only occasionally does it feel like it's missing the beat and not keeping up with the driver's anticipated moves, such as when coasting down to a stop, but then deciding to give it some more power as the traffic is cleared from a light. It gets a little confused at that point and might select a gear lower than it needs to, but overall, the powertrain is smooth, refined, and perfectly adequate to the task of powering the Pathfinder. The overall feel of the Pathfinder is of a heavy SUV, however, especially when negotiating tight turns, roundabouts, or performing hard acceleration or braking maneuvers. Body movement is pronounced in such situations, squatting hard on its rear haunches under full acceleration, diving noticeably under hard braking, and plowing through quick turns with considerable understeer. It doesn't like being hustled along quickly. Slipping the drive mode selector into sport mode does improve the steering feel and feedback, however, but it becomes very clear to the driver that this is the equivalent of a family minivan, not a sports wagon, and that you and your passengers are going to be happiest keeping the Pathfinder at a simmer rather than a full steaming boil. But the Pathfinder will happily simmer along all day with a truly comfortable ride, even on high-spec models that have big wheels and low-profile tires. Road noise does make it into the cabin, again thanks to those big wheels and tires, made even more noticeable by the lack of wind noise to mask it. But the overall serenity of the Pathfinder's completely redesigned cabin is barely affected by the outside world. The new look inside is excellent, with a modern feel and updated electronics that combine with solid material choices and build quality to create a well-done update to the cabin. Seat comfort is good, but we're still not seeing the magic of these so-called zero-gravity seats. They just feel like seats, no better or worse than any others. There is noticeably plentiful passenger space, however, with tons of room up front or in the sliding second row, both in width and in legroom. The third row in many three-row crossover style SUVs is often best used only for children, with a few notable exceptions like the Volkswagen Atlas and Hyundai Palisade. The additional width that comes with the new 22 Pathfinder makes the third row here a usable size for adults as well, especially given the second row's sliding ability, allowing for passengers in the second and third rows to negotiate available legroom among themselves. Ingress and egress into the third row is easy as well, thanks to Nissan's one-touch Easy Flex latch and glide button that slides and tilts the second row, even with child car seats attached. The update to the interior electronics is a welcome one, with an available 9-inch touchscreen multimedia system that's located high on the dash for easy visibility and use. It's accompanied by an available 12.3-inch digital gauge cluster that provides all sorts of information, some more useful than others, and two different configurations that look pretty slick. As with most new vehicles these days, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto come standard, and Wi-Fi connectivity with wireless charging is available. Nissan felt it important to demonstrate that the new Pathfinder is a capable off-roader as well, as the changes they've made to amp up its rugged image are more than just cosmetic. That's why they booked some time at Holly Oaks Off-Road Park north of Detroit for a brief romp through the dirt and mud, showing off the Pathfinder's terrain select functions. Rotating the selector through the options to the mud and ruts function changes a host of vehicle attributes, while a quick push of the central button engages the automatic hill descent control. And with that, the Pathfinder was off to tackle terrain that it's almost never likely to see out in the wild, loose gravel ascents and steep, slippery slopes, which it did without complaint or difficulty. We didn't do any serious rock crawling, but let's be honest here, despite the Pathfinder's looks, this is not a proper off-road machine. It does feature a new clutch that allows for predictive all-wheel drive that no longer relies on waiting for slip to be detected by the front wheels to engage the rears. The computer makes the call before that happens now. But the all-season tires, lack of underbody skid plate protection, and no locking transfer case mean that this is still a soft roader, and that's perfectly fine. You can option up a Pathfinder with accessories that make it a bit more capable yet, but anyone serious about going further off-road is likely looking at a Nissan Titan pickup with a Pro 4X package instead. Let's just say that the Pathfinder will handle rutted dirt roads and family off-grid camping duty just fine thanks to its softer suspension, but you're not likely to ever see one out overlanding across the Arizona desert. Nissan has simplified the trim levels and pricing for the new Pathfinder as well. All options are lumped into the trim levels, of which there are four. Two option packages are available as well, so finding a Pathfinder that has a specific option you want, like the panoramic moonroof or leather interior, means finding the required trim level. The starting price is $34,560, including destination, for a front-wheel drive S model, which is roughly $1,400 more than the outgoing 2020 Pathfinder, while a loaded platinum four-wheel drive model rings in at just less than $50,000. That's a healthy jump over the outgoing model, but it does reflect considerable added standard equipment, the most important of which might be the updated Nissan Safety Shield 360 system, which brings automatic emergency braking with pedestrian detection, lane departure warning, rear cross traffic alert, blind spot warning, high beam assist, and class exclusive rear automatic braking. The Pathfinder also features a driver alertness sensor, rear door alert, rear sonar, and the Easy Fill tire assist as standard, with blind spot intervention, lane intervention, and traffic sign recognition as optional. Nissan's latest Pro Pilot Assist Cruise Control is also available, which helps steer the vehicle on the highway but doesn't let you remove your hands from the steering wheel, unlike General Motors' Super Cruise system. So yes, the new Pathfinder's changes really have resulted in a vehicle that can go a little bit further off-road than the old one might have, but its buyers still aren't probably looking to go that far off the pavement. The new Pathfinder will be available in dealerships soon, and if you'd like to learn more about it, you can learn everything you need to know at Cars.com.